The honeybee colony is a true marvel of biology. And in this series, I'm going to introduce you to the colony, its constituents, the nest, and everything that you need to know from the biology perspective about being a successful beekeeper. So let me first start by describing a little bit of semantics between a colony and a hive or a nest. A honeybee colony is a term for the actual living organisms. Honeybees are insects and they go through complete metamorphosis. So you have egg, larva, pupa, and adult. Collectively, the bees compose the colony. When I say the word colony, I am talking about the living organisms that live and function almost as a single unit. Now, colonies live in nests or hives. Beekeepers tend to refer to the structure in which a colony lives as the hive, but in the wild, we often refer to that as their nest. So the nest or the hive is the structure in which the colony resides. Now, the honeybee colony is fascinating. There's a suite of behaviors. There's multiple members. There's multiple life stages. So as I zero in, I want to think specifically about the three types of bees that collectively compose that honeybee colony. Those bees are the queen, the drones, and the worker bees. Each of those bees, the queens, the drones, and the workers, go through that developmental stage of egg, larva, pupa, adult. And in this series about honeybee biology, I'll be explaining to you those stages, how they work, what happens as bees progress through them. But for purposes of this video, it's just important to know that the colony typically has one queen, maybe a few thousand drones, and then many thousand workers, perhaps 10 to 20 to 30 to 40,000 or more workers. Queens and workers are female bees, while the drones are male bees. And there's this really interesting thing that happens in the colony that's responsible for producing males or females. And that interesting thing is something we called a haplodiploid sex determinant system. Big fancy science word, but what it simply means is that the sex, male or female, is determined by a haplodiploid genetic system. So what do I mean by that? Well, queen honeybees are the individuals in that nest who lay the eggs and are responsible for all of the offspring in that nest. When a queen lays an egg, she can elect to fertilize that egg with semen or not fertilize that egg. The remarkable thing within this haplodiploid sex determinant system is that unfertilized eggs result in male bees, drones, while fertilized eggs result in female bees, queens, and workers. So the queen, as she lays that egg, is determining whether to make that offspring a male or a female. Drones, by extension, because they're from unfertilized eggs, have no fathers. It only took a queen to make him. Drones do, though, have grandfathers. They have a maternal grandfather. It took a male to make the queen, but once the queen existed, no male to make that drone. Workers and queens, on the other hand, come from these fertilized eggs. So when the queen is laying that egg, she'll fertilize it and you'll get this female. But what's remarkable about the female division in the honeybee world is that the queen doesn't really determine if she's going to lay a queen egg or a worker egg. She only determines that she's going to lay a female egg. The worker bees in the nest then take that female larvae and either feed it a lot of high quality diet or less low quality diet to make a queen and a worker respectively. And then once that's determined, those eggs hatch with larvae, those larvae develop into pupae, the pupae develop into adults, and then you have adult queens, workers, or drones. A remarkable system where three different types of bees coming from two different types of eggs work together to advance the colony while living in a defined nest. A remarkable system that I look forward to introducing to you in subsequent videos.